So I'm browsing the interwebs and whatnot, right? And then I look up, how do I get some pussy? Because the nigga is really out here starving. And I happen to stumble across alpha male YouTube. Now, while I'm stumbling across this and whatnot, I see the most beta male bitch ass nigga really got a whole ass YouTube channel called The Alpha Show. This is no hate to him particularly. What the fuck? I just fucked that up so bad. I don't even know what I just tried to say. But no hate to this man. I respect the grind and whatnot. But the shit you preaching about on your fucking YouTube channel is complete horse. Shit, my nigga, this shit is bullshit. Look at this.
Hello guys, welcome back to Alpha Show, a channel that is about to turn you into a fucking alpha. In today's video, I'm going to teach you some simple psychological tricks on how to make any girl, whether she is your friend, girlfriend, co-worker, or anything else, horny as fuck.
Now I know that there is no such thing as beta male or alpha male. That's all kind of bullshit that niggas make up to make themselves feel better and whatnot, but this nigga is a fucking beta male. Like, if you got a whole fucking YouTube channel dedicated to teaching other niggas how to become an alpha male, you're just a beta, my nigga. It's no debate.
Of course it is, which is why today I want to give you a few tricks that are proven to get any girl wet and horny for you in just minutes. Remember, I've gotten plenty of girls in the mood myself, so I know what I'm talking about. Number 1. Let her know you want to fuck her. A lot of men seem to think that they need to be sneaky about their intentions or they'll scare the girl off. But attempting to trick her into thinking you're just being friendly when you first make contact is actually a major, major mistake. Women aren't stupid. If you go up to a girl at a bar and awkwardly make small talk about the weather, she'll see right through you. And if beating around the bush doesn't come off as creepy and insecure, which it almost always does, the most you can hope for by pretending to be her friend is that instant friend zone.
So what he said is low-key facts, but at the same time, it's just fucking bullshit. Like, yeah, if you want to fuck a girl and you try to like play it crazy like you just want to be her friend, that shit is weird, my nigga. Like, say it with your fucking chest, you fucking pussy. But like, what if I actually want a friend, my nigga? If my friend happens to be cute and she happens to be a female, I might try to fuck her, but that's not my fucking priority, my nigga. Like, the fact that he thinks he can fuck every girl that he meets lets me know that he does not get any pussy whatsoever. And me personally, like, if I didn't, like, if I couldn't be friends with the girl and I just want to fuck her, I wouldn't fuck her, bro. Because what if she gets attached and you fucking hate her personality? What if you get her pregnant? Now you got a weird bitch pregnant, and now you got so many more issues than if you would have just kept your dick in your fucking pants, my nigga. I don't know, maybe I'm tripping, maybe I'm a fucking feminist, maybe I'm an incel.
And no guy wants to wind up there. I'll never forget the story of my friend Drew told me a while back. See, Drew was at the party and got a girl way out of his league to sleep with him, using only 4 words. We are going to fuck.
Alright, so at first I didn't trust this nigga, bro. But if he says his man's got some pussy off of this shit, I gotta put this shit to the test, my nigga. Get down. 10 kills on the board right now, just wiped out Tomato Town. My friend just gone down, I revived him, now we're heading southbound. Now we're in the Pleasant Park streets, look at the map, go to the mark sheet. Take me to your Xbox to play Fortnite today. You can take me where Steve Meyer, but not Loot Lake. I really love to truck jug with you. Now, if you needed any more goddamn proof that this nigga is a fucking bullshit artist, there the fuck it is. I wake up, wanna kill myself. How would you feel if I killed myself? I look in the mirror, wanna shoot myself. My worst enemy is myself. First, I thought I was a fucking feminist or some other nonsense like that, but this shit doesn't fucking work. I did everything right. Your mans did not get any pussy off of saying 4 words. We are just going to fuck. You pulled that story out of your goddamn ass crack because I just did this shit and I got fucking spun. I got spinned. I got swept like the fucking fucking Celtics in the playoffs, my nigga. I don't watch basketball. I don't fucking know. But you get the fucking point. It's bullshit.
He even showed me pictures, and sure enough, this girl was supermodel hot, but apparently very standoffish. Every man in the room wanted to get with her, but whenever anyone tried to make conversation, she'd just laugh in his face and shut him down immediately. Now, Drew may not be the most handsome man around, but he knows how to get what he wants. So he marched right up to her, and instead of tribal chit-chat, he simply said, "Hi, I'm Drew, nice to meet you, we're going going to fuck.
Why are you fucking lying, bro? None of this shit ever happened. And if it did, this nigga pulled that shit off of a fucking not safe for work Reddit. Those were not real pictures, my nigga. This shit never fucking happened. And you're a beta male, and I just proved it because you don't got no fucking game, my nigga. I just followed your fucking advice and I got spun, my nigga. I got fucking rejected.
I guess you're not feeling me, not feeling the energy. Baby girl, we can do Plan B. Baby girl, we can do Plan B.